Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and thank you for holding this important hearing and for our witnesses being here this morning. Across the country, we are seeing and experiencing a surge of hate, and as a result, we need to think much harder about the tools and resources we have to combat this problem, both online and offline. While the First Amendment to the Constitution protects free speech, speech that incites imminent violence is not protected, and Congress should review and strengthen laws that prohibit threats of violence, harassment, stalking, intimidation, to make sure that we stop the online behavior that does incite violence. In testimony before the Senate Judiciary Committee in July, Federal Bureau of Investigation FBI Director Chris Wade said that the white supremacist violence is on the rise. He said the FBI takes this threat, quote, extremely seriously, end quote, and has made over 100 arrests so far this year. We are seeing in my state over the last several years, we have suffered a shooting at the Jewish Community Center in Seattle, a shooting of a Sikh in Kent, Washington, a bombing attempt at the Martin Luther King Day Parade in Spokane, and over the last year, we've seen a rise in the desecration of both synagogues and mosques. The rise in hate across the country has also led to multiple mass shootings, including the Tree of Life congregation in Pittsburgh, the Pulse nightclub in Orlando, and most recently, the Walmart in El Paso. Social media is used to amplify that hate, and the shooter at one high school in the Parkland posting said the image of himself and guns and knives on Instagram wrote social media posts prior to the attack on his fellow students. In El Paso, the killer published a white supremacist anti-immigration manifesto on 8chan and message board, and my colleague just mentioned the streaming of live content related to the Christchurch shooting, the horrific incidents that happened there. In Myanmar, the military engaged in a systematic campaign on Facebook using fake names and sham accounts to promote violence against Muslim Rohingya. These human lives were all cut short by deep hatred and extremism that we have seen has become more common. This is a particular problem on the dark web, where we see certain websites like 8chan and a host of 24/7, 365 hate rallies, adding technology tools to mainstream websites to stop the spread of these dark websites is a start, but there needs to be more to be a comprehensive and coordinated effort to ensure that people are not directed into these cesspools. I believe calling on the Department of Justice to make sure that we are working across the board on an international basis with companies as well to fight this issue is an important thing to be done. We don't want to push people off of social media platforms only to then be on the dark web where we are finding less of them. We need to do more, the Department of Justice, to shut down these dark web sites, and social media companies need to work with us to make sure that we are doing this. I do want to mention just last week, as there's much discussion here in Washington about initiatives, the state of Washington has passed three gun initiatives by the vote of the people, closing background loopholes and also relating to private sales and extreme person laws, all voted on by a majority of people in our state have successfully passed. So I do appreciate just last week representatives from various companies of all sizes in the tech industry sending the Senator a letter asking for passage of bills requiring extensive background checks. So very much appreciate that and your support of extreme person laws to keep the guns out of the hands of people who a court has determined are dangerous in the possession of that. So this morning, we look forward to asking you about ways in which we can better fight these issues. I do want us to think about ways in which we can all work together to address these issues. I feel that working together, these are successful tools that we can deploy in trying to fight extremism that exists online. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, for the hearing.